Now, what many don't know is that she was once seeded the number one lady tennis player in the country. Number one. That was back in 1992, before she got introduced to the game of golf. In our CEO interview today is none other than the person charged with the Ministry of Works and Transport. Ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Monica Azuba Ntege. Honorable, you're most welcome to Golf by Centrix.
Thank you very much.
I know it's very hard to get a hold of you, but we successfully managed despite your very busy schedule. You're an avid golfer. What club do you belong to?
I belong to Uganda Golf Club.
Ah.
Yes, since 86.
Fantastic. Most people probably are asking, okay, I've seen this lady somewhere. Who is she? For your information, she is the Honorable Minister Monica Ntege, Minister for Works and Transport. Honorable, just take us through your story. How did you get to this position where you are? Where did it all start from?
I am an engineer by training. I studied in Gayaza High School. I went to University, Makerere University. I went for a building course in Brighton, and I worked with the Uganda Commercial Bank in the construction department. I was at the helm of the construction department. At that time, the bank was doing everything technical. We had all the stuff. So I was heading that department. And after some time, the department was phased out because the bank wanted to concentrate on what the bank knows best. Then after that, I did loan implementation, monitoring and evaluation, after which I headed the Department of Real Estate and Logistics.
All right.
So during that time, right from the time I was at, I started working, I've been graced by the Almighty. I've been, yes, I've been on boards, I've served on boards,
yeah.
Very many boards. Some of them I can't remember, but the major ones I can recall is when we were doing the polytechnic, setting up the polytechnic, I was there, the only female member. When we were National Housing, Uganda Clays, Kilembe Mines, I was on UNRA board, and I was the chairperson of the board of Nile Hotel. I know many people don't know Nile Hotel exists.
Existed.
But it still exists. The hotel owns the assets of Serena. They were concessioned to Serena.
Yes.
But the board is still there and management is still in place. So that it is from there and the activities, that where I was appointed the Minister of Works and Transport.
That's very interesting, because you've talked about you doing engineering at some point, and you know, being on a board of UNRA, and we of course know that UNRA and Civil Aviation Authority, among others, are under you. How successful and how hard is it to kind of manage this, you know, departments?
Well, the departments, the agencies, I call them
agencies.
They are agencies. Mm. They have their own management, but they are under the Ministry of Works. And my work is policy, supervision. I work very closely with the board and the EDs of that of those departments, approving their budgets, approving their strategic plans. So I work very closely with them.
And talking about Civil Aviation Authority, among some of the works that are going on is renovation at the airport. Mm-hmm. How is that going, and what kind of plan are we looking at at Entebbe?
Well, there is an increase in traffic and the cargo, and we are expanding the cargo center. Actually, not expanding, but a new cargo center is being built, and the works are in progress. They're on plan. They will be finalized next year. We are expanding the terminal building. The present one is being built, and there will be a new terminal that will be built. This is within the plan of 4 years.
Let's talk about the Ntege Express Highway for just a bit. Some would think maybe it has been delayed, but we can see some people are already using it. In your view, is it on track? And we know it's going to be the first toll road. Where are the proceeds going to go?
It is on track. It would have been finalized by the end of this year, but there was a delay because of land acquisition, which is always a problem in all our projects.
Yeah. Trying to compensate people.
Yes, because of land acquisition, the project has been extended, but we believe by March, latest May, it will be open to the public.
Okay.
And it is a toll road, so you pay if you are using that road.
Now, being a minister for works and transport demands a lot from you. What kind of leadership style do you use? You know, you have so many people under you. What leadership style do you use to, you know, keep your employees, if I may say, motivated and, you know, keep working?
Well, first and foremost, I have an open door policy because it is important. It is a very big ministry, and anytime each one of us should know what is going on, because as I said, it is big. We have so many projects that are going on. Therefore, if I'm not around, the other one should know what is going on. So we work closely with the PS.
Okay.
We work closely with now the directors, the heads of the departments. We, in those meetings, we are together and we go through everything. So that is my style of management. And open door policy. I know I found the ministry, certain people don't go to the ministry's office.
Certain offices.
But I'm sort of discouraging that.
Okay.
I mean, they should go through the hierarchy, but
true.
I believe when there is something which is urgent,
yeah,
one
and they feel
be
more
able
closer.
To relate.
Yeah,
should be able to And it is happening without any issues. Yeah.
Do you have principles that guide you through life?
Yeah, first and foremost, I consult a lot. I do consult a lot because there are advantages and disadvantages to every principle.
Yes.
But one, I do consult a lot to sort of like to include everybody. But I know when you have to take decisions, what times will come when some people do not take it very well, and you can meet resistance. But I know that I try to be inclusive and I consult a lot. And I believe I'm hardworking. I want to see results.
That is result oriented.
I like to see results.
Okay.
I may not get them.
Fantastic.
But I want to see
you
results.
Want to see them.
Yes.
Fantastic. Now you're a busy, busy woman. Do you ever get time for yourself? And when you get time for yourself, what do you do with your personal time?
Before, when I'd just gotten into the ministry, it was different. One, I was new in the government. And the ministry, like I told you, is big. I had to sit down and read.
Yeah, because it demanded a lot from you.
Understand.
Yes.
Yes, and at the same time, life was going on. There are meetings, there are certain decisions to be made, there are people to meet. So I took like 6 months without playing golf. Maybe once in 3 months, like that. But right now, I'm playing at least at the weekends. I play on Saturdays. I try to play on Saturdays if I don't have family functions.
Many thanks for having come for this CEO interview, but we don't stop there. We are coming back with the golf challenge. I hope you're prepared. What's your handicap?
Well, right now as I talk, it is 9.
Hey, you're one of the highest people with... Okay, one of the highest CEOs we have had on the show.
With that kind of handicap. So we're guessing you're going
to... It used to be 5 before I became a minister.
Minister,
that shows how much I'm playing.
What you're telling us is that you probably started playing golf when you were still in high school.
I started playing golf in the bank when I started working.
Ah, fantastic.
We had a program in the bank for all managers to have a sport and a club where they belong.
Super.
And I chose golf.
Super. So we're going to go to the next segment, which is a CEO challenge. I hope you're ready.
But I don't know.
We'll see what you can do, right? Before we wind up, I wanted you to look into that camera and just give a word of inspiration for that young person who's watching you and, you know, is looking up to you, what words would you give them to help them propel and succeed in life?
Always try to improve, aim higher, thank God, trust in God, and keep walking Uganda.
Everything's easier with a driver.
Even putting.
Supercharging what's been missing. This force that draws me is magnetic. Breaking through this noise and static. Cause with you, I'm
132-footer!
Nothing like it in the world. Rarer than rare. It's not for sale.
I don't want to buy it with money. I want to buy it with a story.
A story.
So, Honorable, welcome to this part two, hole number three at the Lake Victoria Serena Golf Resort. This is the CEO Challenge. You ready for it?
Yes.
Hope everything goes well for you. But before we start, many people don't know this about our Honorable Minister here. She is actually a former number one in tennis. Tell us a bit about that.
Way, way back, I used to play tennis at school, at the university. And just after university, and I played in many international events with my colleagues. We had competitive tennis, and then I've forgotten about the years, but eventually okay. I climbed to be number one in the country. And I represented the country in many countries. But I left tennis for two reasons. Number one, I reached the peak of my performance, and at that time I did not have any competition.
You're also the president of the All Africa Challenge Trophy. What does that entail?
The role is to develop the game of golf among ladies in Uganda, to organize the competitions within each region and every 2 years for all Africa. And I am the president and the one responsible for that.
Fantastic. We are glad we have brought the president of the AACT here. And we want to see how well she can do in the nearest to the whole challenge. You think you're ready for it?
Yes.
Fantastic. Yeah. Let's do this. Honorable, certainly for the president of the AACT to come here and show us what you can do, you've actually lived up to your name. How do you think you performed?
Well, I'm happy I got very near the pin, but I know there have been so many other players. And hole-in-one golf is experience, but also there is a bit of luck.
I'm proud to tell you that you have come second with a score of 4.35 feet.
Wow.
Fantastic. Fantastic. That's such an achievement. Oh. And another thing to note is that on the leaderboard, we have two ladies. Uh-huh. So number one and number two are ladies. Then the rest follow.
Yes, I keep on saying that ladies go to the top.
You go to the top.
Yeah.
Still for the best.
Thank you.
Ali asked you, are you big on music? Do you enjoy listening to music? Does it do something for you?
Yes, I enjoy listening to music, but especially Christian music.
Who do you normally listen to, and what songs do you normally listen to?
I normally listen to Hillsong, not that to me they are the best, but because they are available, and because the church I go to, we do a lot of Hillsong music.
Any song in particular?
Well, this one is not Hillsong, but I like He Knows My Name.
He Knows My Name. Mm. Fantastic. It's been an honor and a pleasure to have you. We know you're such a busy lady, but you came to golf by Centrix, and for that we are very grateful. Hopefully we can get you some other time. Yeah?
Yes, I'm available. I'm always available.
Fantastic. Yeah. Thank you very much for having come to Golf by Centrix. Okay. And have yourselves a wonderful day.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And He Knows My Name wraps up Golf by Centrix today. Of course, we're all about inspiration on the show. Special thanks to Uganda Breweries Limited and, of course, Matthias Schumann International, who dressed me up. He's back at Kisementi. We'd also like to thank Rwandair, Lake Victoria Serena Golf Resort, and, of course, Johnny Walker. Keep walking. Till next time, it's bye-bye.
I have a Father. He calls me His own. He'll never leave me, no matter
is Golf by Centrix.
Brought to you by
Johnny Walker. Keep walking.